You know, when I said that is, it was gonna suck, you should have said, yeah, what the f*** you thinking, pal? You don't need that shit. That's what you should have said.
Behind you. smart.
Yeah.
explain. I didn't get it.
I just orgasm.
Sergio.
Talking shit. Code.
Oh, I gotta wait for the
code.
See the
code. That's the code.
That's the click.
It's click.
That was sweet, man. More tries.
Fucking killing me.
That was a street trip.
It's sweet. I never really had anything like on any trip that I was like going like I really want to do that. You know, I just go and like just wherever we went, I'd be like, oh, I want to do that. You know, I'm not someone who like makes a list and checks it off as I film a part. I just, you know, want to do stuff as I go along.
Did it.
Definitely felt like three separate trips, but like the four dudes that were on the trip, I felt like we became like super good boys by like the third trip, you know, but it was such like separate trips with dudes like Nasty.
What the hell is going on here? Is this a setup?
you know, I just rode it all the way through or whatever. So, you know, props to me or whatever, but mad fun. I went through like 15 pairs of forks and a couple bars, and Haro stayed together pretty well. And
everybody that's picked up a shovel at any spot of those, thank you so much. It was nice meeting you, and thank you so much for letting me come and ride, and all the boys coming out to ride as well and film, because I know how big deal to film out there, man. It's like crazy. Like, you even see little signs when you walk in the trails, no video cameras, you know. It was an awesome thing that I put that pride in their pocket and pretty much let us have a go and just sat back and watched, and like, it was actually a cool vibe, you know. You didn't get any weird feelings anywhere. Thank you so much out there, you know.
What was it was hard to ride with that kid. He would just show up at every spot and just start blasting everything.
Just getting your neck tat, dude.
He's a good kid though. Just didn't know any better, pretty much. He just does what he wants to do.
What's that? I got left. Those guys are way too good. You know, you get to this point and like, they've already done like everything you could imagine, you know. You feel like, oh, I think I could do this, and like, they just like, without even thinking, just do like something 10 times better.
Get up, try it again. He doesn't fall.
What about Kaczynski?
Been doing this shit all day, man. Don't see him complaining.
I lit my phone on fire. I got shot in the balls with an airsoft gun. What else did I do? I don't know. I can't remember.
Take them off, man.
Just four more tries.
I hate California.
I cannot believe you rode away like
that. Xerox is in charge.
Who are you gonna call? F***ing cops? Dude, you're a f***ing...
I should call my boss.
What is your boss gonna do? What is he gonna do? We're not doing anything wrong.
You're not supposed to be up here.
Well, why the f*** are you yelling at us? You've never even f***ing said anything to us before.
I just saw you.
When did you see me?
Hey, Paula. Take a look up.
Paula, suck my f***ing
dick. You see this kid right here? Can you call the cops on him, please?
You can't call
the cops
yourself.
Oh, God.
Wait, yeah, you're the f***ing tax dollars, you piece of shit.
I'm sorry you never had any f***ing fun in your life.
Hold it, watch out for Tony.
Whoa.
You alright?
Right now.
You okay, dude?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Oh, oh shit, off. Oh.
Oh, shit. All right.
You alright?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Oh!
Yeah!
We are here for a dropping in of sorts with Corin Stosur, Luke Parslow, mostly talking about the Range of Motion dirt trip.
Is that the name of it?
Yeah, man.
I was trying to tell people I was going to be on this video, and I said, well, what name is it? And I was like, I don't know. It's in the magazine, dog. The name's even on it. No one told me, dude.
As you can see, it's been a while.
Hang on, man. There we go. Let's get it in.
Yeah, the name of the video is Range of Motion, Corey. Can you explain why it would be called that?
Nah, I did more than Riverside. I could go high, but when it comes to like that setup, that kind of setup, that's just nuts. If it was like a soft foam pit landing,
imagine trying to land on that. Bro.
Or
ankle's gone.
Or that, something you roll
what
out.
About that, what about that big ass lip at caddy? That 9-footer.
Yeah, but then how high is the step up gonna be? Yeah. Remember that thing like that?
Oh,
that big thing.
Yeah,
it was like 10 feet.
But it could be even bigger than that.
All right.
Big.
So, name of the video is Range of Motion. Apparently, news to Corey.
It's a good name, actually.
Thank you.
Glad you guys came up with
it. It took us a while for that one.
I think that's probably why I didn't know, because you guys probably just figured it out.
Yeah, I think we did just figure it out. So
I'm not that dumb, people.
It has been a little while since we've been on the trip, so kind of jogging memories for this.
Definitely.
What's your guys' first thought when I ask you to like think about the trip? Like, what's your first memory?
Traveling in a van.
He hates traveling.
That's the only thing I'll remember to that.
Basically, it was Luke's first ever road trip, and he'd been on one other one, I think, when he was like 16. He must have only drove about 45 minutes.
Yeah,
and because
much.
A 3-hour drive for Luke was the most torturous thing ever.
couldn't sit still for nothing. Yeah, couldn't do it. I hated it. There was one night I remember Keith took us to the trails. We rode pitch black. Oh, we got a 4-hour drive. I'm like, what? I sat in the middle of the van.
It's all right. This is what road trips are about. You just keep moving.
Oh, man.
Keep moving.
Yeah, but like, sweaty clothes sticking, stinky. It was fun though, man. It was so much fun.
What was your first memory? What do you think first back when you think of the trip?
Caddies.
Caddy. Two days at caddy.
And this dude named JT.
His name was actually GJ.
GJ. JT.
I know.
What was it about GJ that jogs a memory?
He just spooked the whole beginning of the first trip, you know, like, ta-da, we're all caddies, the boys are in town, and then this douchebag came around and just started drinking and talking and just kind of putting a damper on things, and I was just like, not one of these dudes. And he was that guy, and it just sucked. And then after that went by, you know, caddies was hard to get used to, you know. Pretty much caddies is what I remember, because that was just like, you know, just showing up to the freaking best trails ever, just like, boom.
Bit of a shocker right off the bat, too.
Yeah, like, out the car, like,
West Coast trails,
East Coast trails are way different. And that was definitely East Coast trails, and we just had to adjust and get right, like ready to go. And it was hectic, but that's the first thing I remember about the whole trip, just saying, hey, let's get the best guys to ride dirt in the world and put them all this spot right here. Ready, go, guys.
We sort of knew that, too. Like, Keith obviously knows those trails really well, so he was like, I mean,
Keith
when
was
he told
the first
he,
person for the trails before any of us. And the last session on night.
Basically, he orchestrated a trip
he
for himself.
He set us up, dude. I think he went there 2 weeks before and got every line dialed and then invited some of the best in the world to show up and look stupid as hell.
Yeah. We're putting on pads.
No helmet.
Nah, I'm cool. Just watch for a minute.
Yeah. Keith's a ringer for sure.
Yeah, man.
Set us up, dude.
But I mean, we didn't just not take you there for one day. We hung out at the trails, you know, went back for a second day. You know, first day was supposed to be a warm-up, everybody figure out what they need to do and stuff like that, the lines they like and all that.
Yeah. One thing about it was, like, on the section we went on, it was all dirt, so, like, we knew no matter where we showed up at, we'd adjust and have fun regardless, and it would be, like, it was, like, a sight to get there to where it wasn't like it. So the trip was just, like, get in the van, get to a spot, get out, session, get in the van, drive to the spot, session, and it was just, like, back-to-back, and we knew we were going to have fun because it was all dirt, so,
yeah.
And it was all something we haven't rode, you know, ever really. And it was just rad to just keep moving and just hit all those spots without having one bad one. You know,
yeah.
We're all dope. So that was really cool.
Obviously, caddy was your favorite. Was caddy a highlight for you too?
Caddy, I've never been so overwhelmed.
Yeah.
You know, I've never ridden that much in my life to where I've thrown up 8 times in a bush. You know.
I think you have overall health problems.
I was just like
shaking.
I was standing there, I can't do this no more, and I took a walk in a bush and threw up, and it was just, you know, it was like a little kid again.
Yeah.
I forgot to eat, I forgot to drink water, I forgot to do anything. It was just, ride, you gotta figure it out, it's so much fun, you know?
Yeah.
But now, posh for me, man.
Nice.
Posh
for me too. I mean, every spot we rode was my favorite, because they're all different, but
What everybody has ever said about posh though, for like all these years, it's all true.
Yeah.
Every single word is not, it's no exaggeration, you know? It is.
It's definitely
it is.
The best trails in the world to roost to kick out the back end. So that's like the ultimate high. Like,
yeah.
It's like a surfer riding pipe, you know what I mean? It's just, that's it.
Was it hard to get out of that boat?
Get out of Oregon Beach.
I mean, a lot of the other guys said too, like, it was like they would show up to a trail spot and it was just a treat to even get through the section, let alone like to try and do tricks. Was just like,
there was some scary landings.
I mean,
man.
We was doing tricks because we was filming a video, but I mean, we really wanted to just roost the back end out for the first week of being there, and then session, and then throw some, like, you know, some runs, put some runs together and stuff. But I mean, it was cool because it was kind of like, you know, it was kind of like they set us up. They're like, okay, here's a spot. Boom, cameras on within the first 20 seconds. How can you just kick out the back end for all day long and try to film a video? You know, try to get something cool.
Yeah.
To me, I was having the time of my life.
Yeah, and then
so
you
I
get on
like,
padded, take your helmet off, throw the cameras away.
Yeah.
Last, he flips a hip, three's the next, oh, shit, man, where's the cameras at?
Locals are just like, give me a fronty, bro, give me a fronty. Just kind of killing my high. I'm just like, oh, here we go. You know, like, come on, see what you got. Hey, flip whip that 45-footer, Luke, you got it.
Nah, I'll let Dennis Edison have that thing.
Yeah.
Like,
that was his.
It was mad, though. It was mad fun. Like, good experience.
What let's talk about filming a little bit. I mean, I think you were a little bit better than Luke, but Luke definitely had a couple moments where he was one particular.
Yeah.
He wanted to flip a step down, and we're like, all right, we need to set up. And he it was like, I was like, just give us a little while, and we'll be ready. And he like goes back over the top, probably waits maybe like 2 minutes, and then comes back around and flips it, and he's like, did you get it? We're like, we're literally there was four cameras there, three video cameras, one actual photo camera, and nobody, everybody was just standing there, and not a single person.
And I look back and I'm like, get it, and I'm like, what did you even ask that for, man? Cameras by the sides and shit, and keeps looking at me going, why, Luke? What are you doing, man? Luke, listen to me, Luke. You're on a film trip, Luke. I'm like, sorry, man.
Yeah, that's the thing.
I'll go back out there, but I'm like, give me some time, please.
That's the thing. Like, there's like film writers that know how to like wait until you guys are set up and work with you guys. We're just spazzes, so we just like we get somewhere and like we'll see like something we need to conquer and make happen, and whether make sure you're rolling because it's like my own test in my own head. So if it, when it happens. So it was a lot of spontaneous, just like. Random, just like you know, things
I felt
you wanted to film that you weren't even ready for. Yeah. We're just like, did you get it? You didn't. Well,
well that's
so
that's
now the rest of the day, like, shit, I gotta figure out how to like.
But it's also good though, like, for once back, you're not just doing a trick two times, three times. You know, you're trying to do it to where it's the best thing because you're filming for it. Which I haven't done that since I was little. You know.
Yeah.
That was going on that trip, man. Was the best thing I've done in 5 years. You know.
Awesome. So, I mean, that's awesome for us to hear, and you know, even with that flip, you were stressing it the first time, and I think the second time too, you weren't too psyched.
The second time, I think I was more scared than anything because I didn't even think the tree was gonna affect me. And the next minute, I'm in the tree. I'm like, oh,
that was nuts. That flip was retarded.
It was fun. It worked. It was the last time I almost didn't though.
Let's see, is there anything else? I do have the trail section. You guys can check it out. Just watch it on camera. I don't know. We can't actually show it. So I have it queued up for you guys. So video is practically done, actually. So
kidding.
Yeah.
What?
Dude, I'm glad this interview was like as soon as it was because I almost forgot about everything we did. We might have to do part two already. Maybe we can get our own part this time.
Yeah, that's right.
That'd be so sweet.
That's right.
So obviously, you guys have this will be on the DVD. So
what?
Shut up. What?
Who's that?
Haka.
God, is he amazing?
Oh! The kid is a weapon! Any shots and oh yeah, Haka! Oh, that worked out cool,
that was
man!
That for you too, remember?
Yeah, that's for me.
That worked out cool. Yeah!
GJ.
Yeah!
GJ!
Cool kid. Where are you going?
It didn't look like you
just went out there.
All jumps are so good.
Can't tell, eh? You cannot tell.
It's just like you can tell some of them though. Like, it's just like it's just so long. This is the flipper to disappear.
Oh. You can't tell that either. Kids just know. Nuts.
Yeah,
things are big and steep.
Yeah.
Bushwhacking on that.
Yeah.
That took me
a minute. It's good crashes.
This is returning.
Smallest jump ever.
What is that?
Look how much of a mud bag he is right there too. Just completely covered.
That's awesome. Brings back memories. Tell you that much. Now I actually remember what it did and how hot it was.
I mean, obviously, you know, video will never translate how crazy some of that stuff is. You know, like
I'm just happy to see dirt back.
Yeah.
You know, like
more leads.
And you know, it's just so much fun, and having the boys on that trip, and the street riders. Like I wanted to say that Dennis Anderson, Dill Wadd. I mean, especially. Are amazing because they hung with us in dirt sections and stuff and it was pretty heavy.
Tony kind of freaked out, bounced.
Yeah, he left.
Which one's Tony?
Which one?
The little guy?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, no, so.
Love you, Corey. What's up, Rosa?
Mad props to those guys for handling like some heavy good times. Yeah, no, good times. Hopefully more.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Be sweet.
More trail trips.
Just so the world knows, we only had 20 minutes to warm up before filming every spot.
Yeah, right. 20 minutes. Cracking the whip.
Don't leave that out. Don't forget that when you watch these parts.
Hey, sometimes 5 minutes.
Yeah, 20-minute practice and then shoot. Good times.
Thanks for coming out. Thanks for making the drive. Thanks for getting out of your sick bed.
I owe you $100 anyway.
Taking me on the trip still.
Yeah, hey, you do owe me $100.
I owe you,
beard
okay?
breath.
I owe
beard
you,
bed.
Okay?